Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about testing methods. So for this video, you'll be learning on the methods of testing and select appropriate data for a given method. So the first testing method will be dry run testing. So the code is manually traced without any software use. The value of a variable is manually followed using a trace table to check whether it's used and updated as expected. So if you look at the picture on the right here, just imagine that we are using a trace table to trace the variables to check whether the variables are updated correctly and producing the expected result. Therefore, it's used to identify logic errors but not execution errors since the code is manually traced as mentioned before. And next will be walkthrough testing. So walkthrough testing is a formalized version of a dry run using predefined test cases. Code is reviewed carefully by the developers, peers, managers, team members, and etc. And it's often done as demonstration to gather useful feedback to further develop the code. So it means that for walkthrough testing, we're going to have some predefined test cases, and then we're going to run some demo, and then we're going to review with our peers, managers, team members, and etc. And next will be white box testing. So what is white box testing? It's a detailed testing of how each procedure works. Basically, it's testing the structure and logic of every path through a program module. And next will be black box testing. What does a black box testing do? Basically, it checks a module is functioning correctly by supplying the required inputs to the procedure and observe the outputs. The outputs are then compared with expected results. So it means that you have developed some module and you know that let's say you supply certain input to this module, it will produce certain output. For example, you develop modules that do multiplication of two numbers. So let's say you put in 2 and 3, you should get 6. And let's say you put in 4 and 5 and you get like 10, it means that the module is not functioning correctly since the answer should be 20. So this black box testing, you actually do not have to know how the code works. You just have to know that let's say you give in certain input and it will produce certain output. Therefore, black box testing only consider what goes in and what comes out of the procedure. The code is viewed as being in a black box. It means that if you look at this picture here, we do not know how the code works actually. That's why it's a black box. We just know we give this input and it will produce this output. It's very different compared to white box testing. Therefore, sometimes black box testing do not require the developer to test because you just have to know what is the input and what's the output. On the other hand, white box testing always require developer to test because they have to know how the internal procedure or logic or program module works. Therefore, black box, you do not have to know the internal working structure of the code, but for white box, you have to know the internal structure working of the code. Furthermore, we have integration testing. So what does integration testing do? Basically, it's taking modules that have been tested on individually and testing on them combined together. This is to ensure modules can run effectively together. Just imagine that looking at the picture on the right here, basically different team members are working on different modules and at the end, they will combine all the modules to form one single project, just like how the puzzles fit together. And next will be stub testing. So what is stub? Stubs are computer programs that act as temporary replacement for a core module and produce the same output as the actual product or software. This technique will allow testing to be started before all the code is written. So let's look at one example. So for example, a main menu could have 5 choices. The procedure code may have been written for 4 of the options only. The 5th choice simply display tested line of text, procedure 5 call. Let's say we want to do a product demo for the main menu and the team member who is working on the 5th option hasn't finished the code yet. So what happens is that we'll just combine the 4 options first. And for the 5th option, let's say someone click on the 5th option, we'll just put a placeholder there saying that procedure 5 call. This is to make sure that we can do our testing or the other testing earlier before waiting the team member to finish the 5th option. Therefore, this is the practical use of stub testing. We also have alpha testing, which is basically the first round of testing, and the completed or nearly completed program is tested in-house by the development team. And then we have beta testing, which is the second round of testing. Basically, the software is made available to a selected number of potential customers for their feedback before it's being released. So I'm pretty sure that you heard beta release before. So let's say you have a new version of OS, and then some people will get invited to test the beta version, or the company will make the beta version available to public. But definitely they will just say that this software is not stable, but feel free to test out the beta version and provide feedback. So this is the beta release. And lastly will be acceptance testing. So what does acceptance testing do? So basically a test is carried out by intended users of the system, which are the people who requested the software. And the purpose is to check whether the software performs exactly as required. The acceptance criteria should completely be satisfied for the program to be released to the general public. So customer will be expected to formally sign off the software as being acceptable. So it means that let's say the customer requested a program with a few features. So the customer has to actually test all the features and making sure that all the features are working as expected before formally sign off that this is accepted. Therefore, this is acceptance testing. I hope you have a better understanding of different testing methods after going through this video. Definitely there are quite a few testing methods to absorb for these videos, but no worries, just pause the video and go through the points carefully. I'm pretty sure you can recall the testing methods after a while. Definitely if you're taking A-level computer science exam, feel free to check out my video playlist split by chapters or papers by referring to the video description down below. Or you can just go to youtube.com/@hagwinschool and click on playlist and choose the playlist that you prefer. And as usual, like, comment and subscribe. Thank you and I will see you again then. Bye bye.